I'm pleased to be welcoming Dr. James Peach, Professor Emeritus from New Mexico State University, where he taught economics and international business for a number of years before retiring. Congratulations on your retirement, first of all. Got a couple of questions for you, Dr. Peach. I'm really interested. I want to ask you about the outcome of the special session just wrapped up this week, the decision by the legislature to send either $500 or $1,000 to singles or couples out there. Filing jointly, the goal in the session was to ease the burden of rising consumer costs. Does this do that in your view?
It could help. It's a far better thing to do this than have additional tax cuts. We will need the tax revenue at some point, given the volatility in oil prices.
Is that number acceptable to you? Did you have a number in your own mind that you thought, well, maybe this might help? Is $500 appreciably good in your view?
Oh, certainly. Yeah. That'll be a big help for a lot of people, especially at the low end of the income distribution. $500 is not going to change my lifestyle or probably yours either. But a lot of people, it'll make a big difference.
In comparison, the move is along the same lines, of course, as the federal stimulus checks we received last 2 years. But those didn't stop the inflation we're seeing now. Are there any precautions we can take now to help prevent a future spike in inflation?
There's very little that can be done at the state level, almost nothing. At the federal level, the measures that are being taken by the Federal Reserve, raising interest rates and reducing the balance sheet of the bank, may help a little bit. A lot of the inflation has to do with things that are not in the typical bailiwick of monetary policy, and that includes oil prices, energy prices, which have been affected dramatically by the war, Russia's war on the Ukraine, and automobile prices, which a lot of that is due to a supply constraint on chips, and food prices are, of course, going up. And a lot of that has very little to do with policies that have been enacted.
What could bring down inflation in your view at this point? Like you mentioned, there's a lot of factors out there causing this kind of pressure. Is there any one thing we can look to ease inflation at this point?
A good part of the inflation in the CPI is due to two things. It's due to energy and it's due to the increase in automobile prices. As the chip shortage eases a little bit, and there are signs that that's going to ease, automobile prices should at least quit rising as rapidly, and that'll have an effect on used car prices. Energy markets are always volatile. That's the whole history of the oil industry, is volatility in crude oil prices. And there's very little that we can do. At the national level, the administration has announced the 180 million barrels, a million barrels a day for 180 days for release from the Strategic Petroleum Reserve. That's not going to affect international prices for crude oil very much.
We are seeing a little bit of price drop, though. What do you attribute that to?
You know, oil markets are so tricky these days that even slight changes in crude oil stocks, slight changes in rumors, West Texas Intermediate hit briefly $130 a barrel one day about 3 weeks ago. And hey, we've got $95 oil, It's a remarkable thing how those markets can change on rumor, sometimes on fact, mm-hmm. but what we can expect in the future is continued volatility.
Dr. Peach, when can we see some relief here in your view? This is my last question. When, you know, on inflation, prices, everything else, what's out there that's going to give us some relief and when?
Well, I think some of the pressures that we've been talking about, energy and automobiles, some of that will go away probably by the end of the summer. Mm-hmm. And I would think certainly by the end of the year, we should be well on our way to returning to some sort of better outlook on inflation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Dr. James Peach, Professor Emeritus, New Mexico State University, thank you very much for our quick time today. Hopefully we can stop in with you and discuss this as the summer and the end of year gets a little bit closer and see where we are. But we appreciate your time today.